And welcome everybody here to the grand final in the Shanghai Major Open Qualifier. This is the EU region. This is Kaipi against Mama's Boys. Mama's Boys were able to actually pick up the first game in about 16-17 minutes. So that was a little bit fast. And because of that, we're already back here with game number two. Kaipi need to win this one or they can come back tomorrow for the second Open Qualifier. So maybe we'll see some more of them. They actually go through to the qualifiers. We'll see it after this game. Essentially, how much we're gonna see less of Kaipi here in the Open Qualifier. So, having all that said, Mama's worried to go back again for the Omni Night ban. Still don't get why they banned the first phase. This laning stage is so weak that you can pretty much exploit it however you want. Invoker, that's a little bit more of a common ban, I would say. Just such an annoying hero. Just so strong as well at the moment, so just taking one out. Kaipi, they don't want to really be playing against the IO of Jepsor again, so they take him out. Gonna force them into a different hero there. Also taking out Nightstalker. Yeah, hero was just overall annoying. Getting it out is more than acceptable. 5 seconds remaining. So with that, Kaipi opened up the darks here for himself over here, so they pick it up. Strong offlaner really just works well with whatever you put it. Mama's Boys, however, they come back with a little bit of 6.85 here. Dazzle Slaughter. Highly aggressive combination here, essentially. Also, just the synergy with the ultimates is so much. And then after you have to use those ultimates, you have their skills as well. Shadow Wave, as well as just crush or all physical damage. So they get so much out of there. So Kaipi picked Omni Knight twice and they won with it, so I guess that's why Mama's Boys are taking it out for now. Duska. Seems like a logical way to do it. Radiant team back. And Kaipi, they also go back actually for the Tusk here, so this is really just 6.85 all over again. 10 seconds. We're gonna see a Gyrocopter ban now. Then a Windrunner, Queen of Pain. 5 seconds. What else from the patch is still in there? That's pretty much like the three obvious ones, I would say. Okay, they're putting in a little bit of 6.86 here by taking out the Viper. And they don't really want to give Mama's Boys too much of an early advantage here. They already have two strong heroes. And I want to force them into a little bit weaker lanes so you can exploit them a bit. Also something, you want to put a hero in mid and Tusk and rotate on. Might even just do Dusk Darkshore in the offlane, that's actually pretty nice. Having the Snowball, double Iron Shell, that can pretty much just devastate anybody if they get close. So this is what Borno, the Statsman, is selling me right now. It's probably either Lance plus Purification, the range on that is pretty long, and having a pure damage nuke is just really strong. So that's the reason behind that, so that explains a lot. So, sorry about that, I was just responding to some messages. I'm actually also the Dota 2 Oracle, so I need to retweet a bunch of the stuff as well. So, let's see. They take a Gyrocopter here from Mama's Boys. That's something I called, if they really want to go with this. Old school build here, they might just go back for the Vengeful here on Mama's Boys. They do have some kind of AoE in the form from Slaughter, but 5 seconds. I think they might as well just go fully commit on Sim, more of the single target way, or the AoE. They need to commit for either of those. At the moment they can still go either way, but they need to watch out with going full on AoE and going into the team fight here. As Kaipi do have Tusk and a Darkseer already. Arguably one of the stronger team fight here was especially Darkseer. Mama's Boys actually go for the Windranger here, this is a combination we see all too often. Slaughter, Windranger, amplified damage into focus fire, it's just so much damage. It's just not fun to see and not fun to play against. Getting chewed through is never really fun. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Having that said, it's It's important that Kaipe actually take out Vengeful here. This is not actually the one that gets initiated on. They have a lot of save. That's the real thing that Kaipe have going here with these picks. Dusk as well as Vengeful are strong saving heroes when someone is stunned up, and Darkseer is just able to give someone the surge, given the movement speed to get out. As long as you're not stunned, that works well as well, but you know, even if you get stunned, you just have the snowball as well as the Vengeful Sweep to save you. 10 seconds remaining. So with that, Skype definitely has a defensive route there going on. I'd go back for the Tiny here. But then you're going a little bit too much into the broader build. Valve wants you to pick ranged heroes with the previous patch, so you might want to be looking a little bit more at that. Mama's Boys, they even pick up the Rubik here now as well. They're gonna go aggressive here. Put the Dazzle, slaughter Rubik, and then put something else in the safe lane. They could do it. Like, there's nothing for them to really stop them from doing this. They're one game ahead, so you can take a little bit of a risk.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Mm-hmm. Seems that Kaipe want to go for the Zeus here, so they're gonna pick up a ranged hero in mid lane. It's okay against wind range, you can really just keep his distance and just spend most arc lightning all the time. We'll see if Cancel has the Zeus. Arcana, that's probably the most important thing here.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Let's see what else. Mamas, would they actually take a BL? That kind of surprises me a bit. This hero has just been, well, hit with the nerf stick pretty hard, and he needs a lot of time to get online. Although Kaipe have a strong early game oriented lineup that can easily play 4 protect 1, I don't think that's the way to go with the Spectre. You really want to do that. You want to go for something that even can participate a little bit more, maybe Spectre, Anti-Mage, or whatever, that can just do more. This is just a bit weird for me. Okay, Mums Boys, they have the option to now decide what they exactly want to do here. There are a lot of things they can go for. They can keep on doing this mid-game oriented lineup, and just take the fights then and try to win it and just snowball from there, or be behind and then win the team fights in the mid-game and just win from there. Like, that's kind of the idea. They could even just, if they go aggressive tri-lane, they will just emphasize a bit more on the early aggression and try to win from there. It's not the easiest of things to do against a Tusk and Vengeful. If those are the supports, Skype can still pick up like a Juggernaut, and Mama's Boys, that becomes a lot harder for them to do anything against him then. It's hard to gank a hero like that. I wouldn't mind it too much for Skype to pick that hero up. Only problem is that the wind range and windrun is just something you don't really want to play up against. That's the one problem. Let's see, apart from it. Not a whole lot of things left.
Clockwork.
Okay, they actually go back for the clockwork here, so it's might just be dual lanes? I think it's gonna be dual lanes here. Maybe Slaughter, Dazzle, and then Rubik, Clockwork. That seems to be the most logical one. They can also swap it around a bit. Or go aggressive try and then have Clockwork on the save. I think that's probably the way to do it. Putting Slaughter in a save lane position is always, with supports behind him, that is, it always feels like you're not really utilizing your lane enough.
5 seconds remaining.
So just, yeah, that's better to just take him out from there.
Reserve time.
Let's see. What can Kaipe do against this? They already have a lot of save against Clockwork, so I don't think they need to focus on that pick, but more on their own personal strategy for now. What will it be? So many options, essentially. It depends on how they want to run it, but they do need a save lane. A save lane, they either want to go and dodge it, the tri-lane coming off from Mama's Boys, Or they want to fight into it and then pick probably a... Yeah, then I'm still looking at the Juggernaut, to be honest. Just go for that hero and just fight with that, but... I don't really think there's too much of a choice if they... If they want to do that, that's pretty much actually the only choice you really have. Let's see, apart from that... You can try and dodge it, but Morphling was not the hero. I was expecting either Greedy, like Anti-Mage or Spectre, or something along those lines, but not a Morphling. You know, or, you know, fighting, getting a Jugger or whatever. But Morphling is... At least I don't have silences, I will give them that. Like, there are absolutely no silences on the side of Mama Boy, so you can just strength more of the hell you want. Nothing really to stop him. So, yeah. Let's see. Yeah, what else is there to do but for them? This just feels weird for me. Picking up the Morphling. It's just a little bit... Yeah, it's not what I was expecting. Let's say it like that. At least. Can you check out Bone7's win rate on the Morphling overall and over the past few months? Because this... Really, just putting your trust in a Morphling in possibly your last game of this open qualifier, it seems really risky for me. But okay, let's just leave it like that for now. I don't really want to go any further into it, as this is, of course, the grand final in the open qualifier in the EU region for the Shanghai Major. This is Mama's Boys, who took game number one against Kaipi. And for Mama's Boys here, we have Piecat playing the Slaughter, Hook is going to be playing the Windranger, Sexca is playing the Dazzle, leaving Jepster on the Rubick. On the offline here, we have Sexy Bamboo playing the Clockwork, of course. For the side of Kaipi here on the Radiant side, needing to win this game if they want to stay in this one. Is Bone7 on the Morphling? All trust is in him here. As Buffney is on the Vengeful, Kia is going to be playing the Darkseer. As Fogamat is going to be playing the Tusk. Cancel is going to be mid on the Zeus. And he doesn't have an Arcana, so... That's not good. That's not good at all. Hook actually went fully into the Magic Stick here. Completely ready in Magic Wand, of course, and yeah. Got a little bit of Spotted Tango as well, some health pot already, so he's just completely ready for it all. Buffney is here now, so. Wants to go bottom, really. They can put on a nice amount of aggression here, Sexy Mabo, but he's already taking out some of the creeps, so he should just be fine, just taking the creeps underneath his tower, should be able to get him his level 2. I guess they're already taking a lot of damage from these iron shells. Does have a mango to give him a little bit more, but there you go, Jeffrey's already crushed up. He was a little bit too far aggressively forward, and oh, the Shadow Wave dealing pretty much just full damage there, and they need one more click, and Jepster will be the one delivering it. First bot here going the way of Mama's Boys. How's Hook doing on his charges? Already got 3 going his way. Cancel's just spamming out his Arc Lightning a little bit too much, I would say. Maybe that's better. Text memo, just take some of the sweet, sweet experience here. Oh, and even the CS for him there. Even 4. He's CSing like crazy. Even a bunch of denies as well. It's already going pretty well for him over there. Kia, Slaughtering Recipe is ready. I'm back for the Stout Shield as well. At least with this new camp here, it's just for offlane heroes that can also go back. Oh, they actually get a kill on Zeus. Nice kill there coming out from them. Making it 0-2 already here for Mama's Boys. Yeah, losing your Zeus here, that's actually pretty devastating. They need the Zeus to really start coming online early, just so they have, can get that aggression going. Okay. Let's see. Limbo. That's Fury Fire. Bunch of people have Fury Fires. They're actually diving beneath the tower. Oh, Surge comes out and Pocket is too late. On his crush there. We'll be able to put some more pressure on the lace. What? Oh, they see him. They see him. They see him. What's doing here? They're gonna get rotation in from multiple heroes here. The question is how well will it work out? Pocket actually whiffs there on the crush. Another rotation is able to connect here. He doesn't have shards, so he would just have to snowball forward. Going for Pocket here. Sexy is also in the back. But, oh, that shadow wave just turning it around. Pocket now also has to start burning. They already lost one. They don't want to lose more, but they lost him. Sexy picking up the kill here. And with that, it's already 4 for Momobus boys, but it seems to be a nice rotation in. But Zeus, somewhere in the middle, actually just walked back and left him there. I was not expecting that from them, and that was just not the thing that they needed to do there. That was a bit of a misplay, and they are immediately paid. Have to pay the price for that one. Oh, that really just surprised me that they let the one go like that. Yeah, this is not gonna be fun. Damn. Even though 52 matches are not a lot of matches on Morph. We'll see how it goes. I wouldn't have put too much faith in it, to be quite honest, when you see stuff like that. Especially if you're gonna play it in your final match, possibly of your qualifier. You only kind of want to go for a bit more of a comfort pick, strong pick that you like as well. They're gonna set it up. What can we do? Cancel doesn't seem to be too willing to go for it. Getting a ward here for himself. We have to watch out where he places it. Yeah, this, if he just throws a one arc lightning, he's actually gonna find this one. And they might have actually seen him place it as well, if they checked his inventory in time. I'm not 100% sure if they did that, because otherwise they would probably already put it on and eaten it with the Tango. Yeah, definitely hit pretty hard. Absolutely nothing on him. Yeah, he's already level 4, so he's getting a lot of experience. Also 12 CS, but at the moment, really sexy Bembo. Level 5, 16 CS, he's having a great game so far. And there you go, they did the task pool. Like I said before in the previous cast, I talked about it a little bit. You can actually pull the Ancient Scap with a Tusk. Does leave Hook to do that. I don't think they were going for a kill, so I will just quickly explain it. At about 53, I think, maybe a little bit later. You just watch where the creeps are. You just hit it here as a Tusk. You walk like this. Once you see the creeps about here, you just throw down your shards like this. You block this off. The Ancients will walk like this, so you need to eat, I believe, 1-3 out of here. And then they just go down like this, and they take the creep wave with them. That's it. Clockwork will finally be killed here. Well, level 5.5, so that's at least not too bad for him. I'm just scared of the DD here. Do they want to do something with this? Jepster is again farming up the camp here, and Jepster just keeps on taking experience away from him. Okay, that would be great, Lizard. If you can join in. I actually didn't expect it was as strong as the splash at the moment. So, whoop, he's gonna be found. He's running. He's not even wind running. He's just walking away. That's ballsy. Guess he was maybe waiting for more. We'll see how crazy strong Morphling is this patch. Oh, fucking mad, he's gonna be found up here. Lifted up, thrown back. DD is really just activated here and taking a lot of damage. But this snowball, this is really just buying time. He goes straight into Hook, and Hook should probably be more than ready for it. Sex even walked in to be sure of it as well. They want to go and cancel here. They keep the aggression going. Oh, what a random career coming around, but I can't really do anything about that. Shadow Boy is going to hit him as well. Cancel now is going to go down here as Hook now comes in to help them out. There's four people here. They're actually trying to TP in more people. There comes out the telekinesis strong in back. Oh, nice shot. Actually knocking them, all of them in here. Keenheart is not really going to do anything at all. Jepstra has to use it on himself here, but Sexy Mabo is getting low, but the body blocks are there, keeping him alive. Oh, no. Magic Missile and Bomb Right Click is all that is needed from Buffy to kill him off. Fucking Matt seems to be able to run away for now, but they're trying to go both ways, and maybe the fucking Matt can just run the other way. They do have more than enough vision of him, they see him walk. There's gonna be the section coming in. Ooh, Power Shot just barely missed on him. What they gonna do now? Yeah, he's gonna get caught up, he's just wasting time. Maybe he can get to the Ancients if he's lucky. No, he's not juking correctly. He's actually walking back. Maybe Roshan now. It would be an option. Oh no, the rocket flare! Oh, Sexy Mambo, he was ready for that one. And now Zeus. He's really not having too good of a time. Yeah, just 2.5k gold is not a lot. Especially if you look at what he has. Casual Ultimate Dirt thrown out, maybe to help out here on bottom, killing Sexy Mambo. The damage was a bit lackluster and weren't able to kill him. He's okay, even gets another creep wave as well. Roman's luckily after next the upcoming creep wave, or even now we'll just go back and look for something aggressive here with his hookshot. He's level 6 now, has a TP, it's gonna cool down 20 seconds, so after he regen up, he will most likely go for somewhere and get a gank going. Some weird tweets done on the Dota 2 qualifier thing there, so I'm sorry about that. See? Oop, yeah, that's a little bit too far. The amplify damage up, that's gonna be nasty. Oh man, they're gonna go for a gank here in mid, who's gonna be found. He's gonna get killed up eventually, there you go. Sexy Mabo, he's locking himself in with others, that's not really his plan. He even gets blocked by the creep buffs. Then Lightning comes out to just secure the kill there and turn into an easy 2 kills here, coming out for Side of Papi. Not willing to let all of these early kills just go in the favor of Mama's boys. Wanna make it a bit more even, Jepstra, ooh, just barely dodges this one. He actually walked forward, it's kinda surprising me, as now fucking Matt is able to initiate on top of him and there comes out. The wave of Bone 7 killing him off. TP's coming in here. Sexka? There is a Wildcat in the back here, smoked up, but I think they're all a little bit too fast and a little bit too far. They do have a blink ready, so they kind of want to fight now. They even smoked up for it. This is not gonna work. See how's it going? Darkseer, no boots, but I started his path towards the mechanism pretty close, just 500 of it. Dire's top tower is under attack. Would be a pretty nice benchmark once they get that. Zeus seems to be going back for a 4-step, just wants to get his mobility going. Also, just getting any kind, any 4-step is always good against a blocker. At the same time, Bone 7, he's gonna be found up here. He's just strength morphing strength all the time. Is he able to get out? He's gonna waveform away for now. Bycat seems to be unrelentless and wants to keep on going. Now the hookshot comes out. They really just want to lock him down. They need a little bit more damage and they have enough damage as well as lockdown and control to keep him there and kill him off. Bone 7 is now death. That's his first death of the game. Nice game coming out there. They really need to stop morphing there and just drag the game a little bit more back into their favor. from me there.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Hook seems to be going for the Agonist build here, just wants to tank up a bit against his lineup. Not a bad of a choice here. Not a fun choice, but it's a good choice. Chexka, walking there was a bad choice. They're wondering a little bit if they want to go into him. They will finally commit and they kill him off before he can use his grave. And with that, he just goes down. And the pick up another kill here. Yep, sir, he's trying to look for the telekinesis here on cancel, but that doesn't really work. I think most boys say they're okay with waiting still a bit. The lineup will come online in about 6 minutes, a little bit more once they get some more levels, as well as the Aghanims here on hook. Once I have that, they can really just go. But anything, but they need to make a move pre 20 minutes, because otherwise you might already be looking at the Blink Dagger on the Darks here. You don't really want to fight into that. Cancel will be able to get some farm up going his way as well, making him harder and harder to kill, and just every time you wait, you give space to a Morphling, and it's just something you want to do. It's already CSing pretty nicely here. It's almost a top farmer again. I'm just taking the position over from the Wind Ranger, so 1.3k gold, it's... what's he gonna go for? It seems like a Lincoln first, so... nothing too interesting from that, just pretty old school. So nothing weirdly new for them, nothing dragon lens or whatever. Just a plain old just a plain old. He's ready with the hookshot, but he's kind of showing himself, so I don't think he can get off in the hookshot without being stopped. Or at least once he tries it, they're gonna get a swipe out, or maybe even a snowball to save. But that doesn't matter for them. They're gonna just go for Roshan and leave him there, trying to keep have him as bait. The Bone 7. Oh, if he can go Infus here, do they see him walking? I think they saw him walking. Same time, they actually have no vision here of the Roshan pit, so they can still walk in here if Almost Boys wanna do it. But they do know that Kaipi is around, they do know that they're walking here. And with seeing them, it seems like they're willing to actually just go for a kill. They want to get pickups first before they go for Roshan. Probably the better call to make here. Seska is going to show himself first. But they actually stopped the attempt here. Kind of surprises me, Seska is now kind of on his own. He's getting low, but Grave in the end will... keeping alive, and they are able to get at least fucking med for now. Who else is going to be found? Bethany is going to be able to TP out. Delayed on the power shot there to stop it, and that's the kill that they want to go into Roshan, it seems like. They're going to start walking in there. Darkseer is still pushing on top. Mid lane is also being pushed in by Bone 7. We'll rotate towards top now as well to help Kia push it in over there.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
There you go, they're gonna start laying in the damage right now. Amplify damage is up, focus fire as well, and with that, Roshan is not gonna be having too good of a life here. We'll have to drop his Aegis soon. Maybe Kaipi can help him out a bit. They're rotating in with 5 here, smoke is ready. Oh, there comes the Tentacles right, and the damage here! The magical nuke is just too much. Bycat in the end will be saved in time. And Bone 7 actually picks up the Aegis as well, skills Roshan. This is just completely turned around here on Mama's Boys. They lose 4, they don't get Roshan, don't get an Aegis, and this is 3 points. This is like 3.8k gold swing easily, maybe even more if they lose a tower now as well. They don't have a fortification, so they can't even stall time. This is a big loss for them. That's just setting back really, really hard. Bycat seems to be either going for Maelstrom or Midas. I'm gonna expect it to be Midas. Maelstrom is not usually something you see picked up on the starter, so. Sexy Bambo, he just loves his Midas. He's probably one of the people that pick it up most. Yeah, there was a little bit of a wait there before we tested his Drusel there. Now comes out the Cox as well, keeping him in. With the... Is he gonna get help from his teammates? No, he's not. At the same time, Sexy Robo does get help from his teammates. Bueno, could you check up on how many times Sexy Robo actually purchases Midas, let's say, the past 2 months? This seems like a pretty nice benchmark. Yeah, you can counter Morph, of course, with an Elder Titan. But then you have an Elder Titan on your team. And I think they picked it as up as 5th and last hero. So cancel. Okay, he's building up for his Eater Lance. Not too surprising that he goes for that. Buckman's looking for a bit of a solo kill. Can he find someone? Hook is way too high on HP. Pycat as well. I guess the best option here is Jepster, but even he's not the easiest of kills. Especially with Sexy Bobo here nearby. I'm pretty sure he doesn't know that for sure. Cancel just shows himself. They're going to try and use him as bait, maybe. Not showing everybody, but he's behind him as well. I think it's a bit obvious of a bait right now. Focus Matt is if his bait rune is going to end up now, so he has to start walking back. Eaterlands is now complete as well as Zeus. There we go. And he's back. Okay, and now Hook almost has his Agnims completed. After that, he'd most likely be looking at the Blink Dagger there. Though it's a little bit of ways off, same time Bo7 has been able to complete up his Lincolns here. From now on, we'll see what his build is gonna be. Where the hell did you go? Oh, too bad. Anyway, so, what can he go for? He can go for the. He can go back for the Interior Blade now. Just get this big burst going. Top tower is under would also be pretty nice against the lineup of Mama's Boys. It's a lot of physical damage at the moment. And even later as well, so... Going for that is more than good. Bit of a long build-up and you will get it pretty late, but still pretty worthwhile item, even to just save your teammates. On the other hand, the other builds would maybe be go for Skadi, Manta, Butterfly. I prefer to get hybrid items on a hero like Warfling, just because he kind of wants everything. Go for Skadi, just gives you HP as well as just damage as well and control, so it wouldn't be too bad. My problem is though, he's actually not an MKB hero, so once Hook gets going, killing him off once the run is on is going to be nearly impossible for him. And now Kenzo comes in, 4 steps forward, and the vacuum misses. Sexy Bambo, he hooks just away towards his teammate. It should be more than okay for now. The Mama's Boy really wanna fight into this. They don't have the initiation to run now. Same time, Bo7 is more than happy to just keep him pushing and leave the losers behind. Well, he goes off and away. Does mean that the tower can be denied now if they want to, and it seems like Hook is willing to do that. They even gave it to Saksha, but how nice of a dice. So Sexy Mabo has about 20% buy rate of Midas on the clockwork, so it's not too much though. Overall it doesn't get bought too many times. So we get bought level, what is it? 5% of the games that clockwork is played, so it's not too much. Now he's gonna start his build up. What should probably be the Aghanims. Having that low cooldown hookshot is just so nice. Goes for Big B. Affinity. Just so nice. It's one of the better Aghanims there is. Question is, who really wants to start making the first move? Like, you can't really go after Bone 7. Because look at this, he just goes in and goes back. If he actually got caught up there with the telekinesis, that would have been really, really funny to see, but it doesn't happen. Even then, it will take a lot of damage to kill him off. They don't really have anything to stop his strike morphing going on. Well, cancel. Yes, his rune did a lot of damage at the section. They might want to go into on this. Bone 7 goes aggressively forward, puts out the Devastrike, and there comes out the vacuum wall onto it, punch into the air. They're gonna lose the Rubik now. Hook is gonna be the next one to fall. No, Griff comes out in the end. Is he able to turn this one around? No, Magnetism comes out. Can he do enough damage to Matt? No, he can't, as the stick charges also come out to keep him alive. But they want more. Bone 7 is on the hunt. Swap comes out. What? This actually kinda helps him. And now he goes towards his teammate. Nice play there also from Session Bow, keeping his heads up and. It feels it was like it was even a little bit awkward for Kaipi themselves. And Blink forward, Pikett goes down here. Ooh, gets some nice rotation in from him. Killing off the low HP, Slaughter there.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Earlands complete here on cancel. Might be going back for the ear, the blink. I think he's talking to his team right now. What does he need to do? Should I go for blink or should I go for something else? That's ooh. I get a killer here onto the actually fight Luffy here as well. He's gonna be shoved up now. He goes down. As let's see, what is Jepster gonna do here? He actually already did. He stole Morph and has now put everything straight into strength. So it is 1.6k. Strength Rubik. Do think he needs to get some armor now. Maybe go back for Tranquils. Just needs to get some armor going. Having zero armor is a little bit troublesome. So just go take that one away. Get yourself some armor going now and you will be really, really happy. It's pretty cheap to just even just pick up a casual. Let's say Jamie or something will help you out. But I think Tranquils will be the way for him to go. They already have an arcane, so he doesn't really need to pick an item like that up. So while Sexy Mabu is getting close towards his what seems to be his endgames right now with Overclock as well. And they start laying in the damage here. The creep camp is not gonna see light of day for too long. How's it going at the moment? Net worth wise, still pretty hefty in favor of Kaipi here. Same goes for the experience. Question, I think I have the feeling that Kaipi are not really a team that need to make the play right now. They're also okay with sitting back a bit more and farming it up. All kind of depends on how in the end Mamba's boys initiate. Like, Kaipi can't really go and initiate a fight, it's pretty hard for them as well. Both teams do have a lot of initiation. So that's pretty nice. See, build up for Bone 7 right now. He bought the Ghost Scepter, so this might be just a casual one or just get an Ethereal Blade as well. Like I said before, Ethereal Blades, this game is pretty good. A lot of physical damage to be stopped, as well as you can just deal a lot of damage yourself. Radiance top tower is under attack. Roshan is now also back up. Maybe we'll see another big fight coming there. We have to keep in mind previous fight there from Mama's boys didn't really go the way they wanted. They got a 4 or 5 man wipe against them and. They didn't get the last hit on Roshan and didn't get the Aegis either. So, with that in mind, Kaipi might be more than willing to go in there. Arcane Wound will now end on cancel, so not really able to utilize that one too much. So let's see. What's going to be the game plan right now? I think both sides really just want to take Roshan. So for now, just pushing out the lanes and then looking for... most likely pickoff is the best way to go at it. Smoking in is a little bit too obvious for the side of Homeless Boys. They can just keep on sending out a rocket flare there to stop them. And Kaipi, they just go in. There's a rocket flare that's going to come now here. There you go. Now I need to go back already. Like, this is what I was talking about. Like, you can do that, but it's a little bit too obvious. Same goes for Mom Boys. They just need to keep someone close. And even then, they have Tunico's Rev to check out where everybody is if they really need to. Well, snowballing. Yep, sir. He has a snowball for himself now. He's gonna get used up first now, but... okay, there comes that snowball. Where is he gonna go? He's actually gonna go towards the creeps here. Oh, he's trying to get out here. There comes the telekinesis as well, but in the end, there are four people from Kaipi surrounding you. There's only one way out, and it's going back to the well. All points indicate here that Bone 7 is actually gonna go for the Ethereal Blade. Taxi Mambo. He has his Agnes completed if he wants to buy it out, as he will do now. Podcast going for the BKB here. Also has a Midas. Hook. Also going back for the BKB, not for the Blink Dagger, as I was initially expecting. Texka, he has his Glimmer Cap ready as well. Gensel, he got the Yules that we just saw come in play. Buffney, Glimmer Cape going into Vlad's right now. Should be loads, right? Yeah, there's gonna be loads for fucking man. Yeah, he has Greaves as well. He has the Blink Dagger here, so he's pretty happy as well. So we're now gonna see. Will Bone 7 buy out on the Ethereal Blade? He seems to be walking towards the Secret Strong. Taking the Strong. Yes, it's gonna be the Ethereal here. There we go, he got it! He did it! He got the Ethereal, he's gonna go that blade. He got the blade, the Ethereal Blade. He will do it! He's gonna get the saves going as well as the kills. For now, okay, so let's see, after this you still kind of have like your roots open, you can still go a lot of ways. Still going back for Monster, still more than acceptable. Skadi does a good BKB. It's okay. They don't need it too much. Especially since he has saves. Yeah, I think I like Manta the most. Also to get off amplified damage. This is the overall item is really strong. Man. Going back for Dragonlance wouldn't be too bad either. But okay, they're gonna fight Sex Guy and he's not really able to do anything. Apart from dying. Okay, man, just taking a lot of hate here, but we'll be able to survive through it all. There you go. Rubick got the Tranquils like I expected. At least has some armor now before Weave, so. Damn, 24 armor on Bone 7. That's a lot. Pardon me there. Hook seems to be looking for a kill here. Cancel. Power shot it. Horse theft. TPing. 0.0 and he is out. Buckets. Too late on the bridge there, and even then I don't think it would have connected. So he's just A-OK over there. Almost boys, yeah. Pretty much the lead for Kaipi is stagnating, it pretty much stays around the same. As they're just eyeballing this Roshan pit so much all the time. Both teams really want to get it. It's, oh no. Pokemon is found, but Telekinesis gets returned there. And they turn it around with Sexy Bamboo. Lotus Orb, too fun against the Rubick here. Pretty much everything he does is returnable apart from Spell Seal. It'll be pretty weird. Of nowhere, extra skill slot. Hey! We can do it! Woo! Even then, Lotus Orb. This game is actually pretty strong. You also have the Power Shot and Fox Fire to turn around. Oh, what? Oh, they're going to Roshan, that was running out. As well as Poison Touch, but it's not leveled, so that doesn't matter too much. Amplify, Returned, of course.
That's actually it, not too much, but still some nice skills to just give back.
And Roshan has finally been taken. Took him a good 10 minutes of eyeballing, pretty much. It's now Hook. It's gonna be used up. Bone 7 is ready. But he was his TP out, but there comes the swipe from Buffini. Yeah, that's gonna be your 10 second BKB down. That was not worth it at all. Oh, Lotus Orb. Snowball. Onto Yapster. It's gonna connect. What can he do now? That's a blink in one, but the urn will prevent it from blinking. Now, shards have been returned, and Sesca is actually able to get up the grave in time. And he glimmers up as well, but he can't really do anything in the end, he'll just die here. Just trying to stall a bit, as there's still about 25 seconds left that they don't have their Windrunner. So they're gonna start pushing into the tier 3 a bit, we'll do some damage once the timer for Windranger reaches about 5 seconds, we'll probably back up. But for now, they're more than willing to just put in the damage. Hit. Taking a lot of damage from the magic nukes here. By cat! They were a little bit too early for him, but now the hookshot comes out, but they know they can't really do anything about it. Lotus Orb as well. Neva swap back. They're gonna take the tier 3, and I think they should probably return for now as a nice check shot comes out here. Bone 7 is willing to keep on going. He can go back towards his team. Oh, hookshot! But it kind of gets blocked here by Key, and he just pulls him back with the back. They want to kill off Section Bower. Spikehead comes in with a 4-man curse with the BKB on. He's farming to Wreckface and Bo7. Can he use anything here? He still has the Aegis as well, so he's actually okay with dying here. He doesn't mind it too much, but they do lose 1-for-1 at the moment. He comes back. Waste forms out. And it seems like Kaipa just want to return. And Robus Boys, can they really do anything against it? Ooh, nice to be crush here, but he can't really stay too close. Sprint comes out, and Vacuum back now as well. Oh, it's Aerial Blade. Yeah. He just played with his life, and that kind of signals the return here. As well as Hughes coming out, and the Swept as well. Ooh, Hook, he needs to get out of here. And they see him now again, and trying to return the damage here and cancel, but he just can't dish it out in time. Now, the first buyback is going to be used here by Sexy Bumbo. I don't think this is enough though to get him back. They need to buy back on one more. Hookshot in, doesn't really matter, like it just buys him time. They're gonna get the Melee Rex for now, putting in more. They really wanna get this and they should be able to do so. There comes out the Tyrael Blade. And oh no, he gets cut out, he needs to get out, and he is not able to do so. Was not able to return back to his rep. The cats walking around the map, so yeah, it's a little bit painful. And with all of that, in the end, it's still in favor of Kaipi. I don't think they had to lose their Morphling there, that was just a little bit too aggressive. You could have just replicated back after you got the Rex, but he wanted to stick around for that half millisecond too long, then he just had to pay the price for that. Still, you can see the net worth just going up and up and up. Pike it, TPing out, yeah, they're gonna stop this one. Should be able to escape, I don't really think they have enough lockdown. Swap is coming out. They have a magic missile now, but actually they do not. They don't have the mana for it. Maybe if he threat switch, does he have threats? He does have threats. If he threat switch, he would have had the mana for it. But now, seems like Woman's Boys looking for some return aggression on them. Power shot, I think they might have just seen Gaina here, but he has a blink and he has surge as well. Should be able to get back to her space. Don't think they really want to fight, and I don't think Sexy Bumbo is going to hit a long shot. It would just opt to go for a neutral Q. Oh. Zeska's going on a bit of a scouting mission here, but he's not spotted out. Ward vision on both sides is pretty lackluster. This is the Dire vision right now. This is the Radiant. Ouch. Mobus boys, they got their work cut out for them. They've never come back from this deficit that they've only played in this qualifier so far. So the pool of games that they have played is like 7 or something, so it's not the biggest one either. But still, it's a big deficit to come back from. But as it has been shown before, it is not impossible to do so. That everybody is just going back to it for now. Okay, they know the gig is up. Turner got refugees, they know that they have been smoked. He's gonna go, probably go back towards the tower. Throwing out here, Bone 7 says, let's just go towards their jungle and try to end this. They are pretty big lead, so they could of course try it. It surprised me that they don't want to get Roshan this time around. Yeah, so they go forward here, they want to kill Bone 7 here, hookshot comes out. What's stopping the definitely distracted? No, Jepser, he's getting low, he's gonna go down. Pycat came in with BKB here, but he's not really doing a whole lot of damage. Bone 7 is being focused up, but he's still alive and he just goes out for now. As another hookshot comes out from Sexy Bambo, but it's not gonna be enough. Now let's see what they're gonna do about Hook right now. It's hooking and jiving, Shard's not gonna connect. Snowball will. Windrun is gonna end about now, and he's gonna be used up into the air. They're just gonna throw the magic missile on top of him and he will be killed. As all we all, Bone 7 in the end has been able to survive through it all. He's gonna be building towards the Skadi here, most likely. As a Morbid Mask, casual. Oh, he's gonna look for Pycat here. Doesn't have the most of HP. Pycat needs to get out. He can blink, but he can blink towards here. Oh, Waveform doesn't connect and he can blink! But now the blink comes afterwards. Cancel, but Cancel doesn't see him! He misguessed that! We saw him and he just already pre-casted it. That was not worth it. That was not the play. Same time, the tier 3 on top is taking some damage. It did take out the range packs. Lift up is gonna come out on Buffney. Just throwing back, you know, like getting on the tower hits. That said, he just limps himself. He's gonna go for the long range Aghanims here. Whew. That's gonna be fun. That's really big initiation too. Pycat. He needs to get himself a TP or something. He might just be spotted here. Pycat? Pycat? Pycat. And that didn't really not work out at all. Back comes out just on the creeps here. Shoot forward again. Shoot backward again as well. Cancel's down and it's still putting out so much aggression. I guess that's what you get when Pycat is down. It was actually mega killstreak going the way of Slaughter before he died. That's a lot of good money for him. It's 3.3k gold here. What will you go for? AC probably. It will help out his team the most. Otherwise. What would you otherwise get? It's not really. Usually you don't have this luxury. You can always, of course, go for Heart of Thrask if you want to tank up. You go for Heaven's Halberd if you want to disable the enemy. As well as get some evasion going your own way. And they already actually have a Manta, so you don't really want to go for Heaven's Halberd now. It's not the best item. We'll just see what he goes. I don't really want to guess too much about it. Dembo has to take some step backs. DPI from CSK, are they able to stop it? No, they're not. I think they will just be more than content with taking Hook here. It's already Monster Kill now, Kia. Doing pretty strong. Hookshot? That was just a gesture, so that's not really the best way of initiating. Unless you want to initiate on your own team, but now the war response comes out on Sexy Bamboo. They really want to kill him up, but that comes back on two. Grave has also been put on him. You want to keep him alive, but it was maybe a little bit too early. He now needs to walk back with just a little, with a slimmer of HP. Same time, Pocket is trying to get some confusion going, but that's not going to work out as he just gets killed off right now. Even gets swapped back for good measurements, and they lose another Rex as well. This seems to be going into the game three here. Tier 4s are taken. This might just be the last hold here. For moments, we're to get a 2-man shackle here. Hookshot is doing a lot of damage. Either blade was actually using him, but the BKB was able to purge it up. Now Hookie just gets pulled for rain, and this is GG. They can't fight against it anymore. Taking too much damage. Sexy Bamboo will also go down. Oh, this is just the end for them. No, Jepsor is there on his own. He gets Yule Scepters up. He's gonna go down. He has the missile, but what can he do? He throws a magic missile, but he just wants to return some of the favor, and that is that here in game number 2. Few moments, boys, in Taipei. We're gonna go game 3 here with them in the EU Open qualifier for the Shanghai Major. I'm at Sanon Scudotto. With me on the stats is Ed Borno. Dash. For the game 3, I think Lizard, old NY player or still an NY, no one really knows what the hell he's doing, is going to join me for game number 3, most likely, I hope. And with that, I hope to see you all again. I think Borno will also hope to see you all. And so, we'll see you then.